I often get a couple of angels turn up and they tell me what I must do. Or I get thought transference and it tells me what I must do. But it's generally, if I can make it brief, bringing down an energy through me and strengthening that energy, really feeling it very, very powerful, and sending it right down into the earth. That's what I do quite often.
Through thought?
It's a mental, both imagery and the fact that you can image it and feel it. It's a reality.
Mm-hmm.
So you know it's reality because you can feel the energy coursing through, you see, and strengthen it. I did this once in Kenya, which they told me to do, and it was so very, very powerful. I could not stand after that. I had to be supported by two people who were with me. I literally couldn't stand upright on my own. That's how powerful it can be. Not always that powerful. Or when I was in Australia, I was walking along a particular place that they'd asked me to go to. And some ETs were communicating, and I knew they were ETs communicating. They were saying they'd come from the stars and that I was to strengthen the colours. They said, see the colours. This is in the book as well. And the colours were all wishy-washy, faded. And they said, strengthen the colours, strengthen the colours. So mentally, again, I intensified the colours, you see, and that's what they wanted me to do, changing energies again. But the communication is always through the mind.
Now, one would think that these space brothers coming from different planets wouldn't all speak English.
Thought.
So it's thought. So
thought is an international language.
The translation occurs within the pattern of vibration arriving, the thought arriving.
If I can explain, I went to a conference in space and there were all these glorious beings there. Now, I wasn't alone. There were loads and loads of others there. Oh, it was magic. And I asked Andreas, who was one of my guides, who I couldn't have gone there without him. He took me there. How is it that everybody understood what the top men were saying? He said, it's thought transference. It doesn't have a language. So everybody's receiving it in their own language because thought is, it doesn't have a language of its own.
It's universal.
It's universal. So it has to be an energy thing. I don't know. But I could understand everything, and they understood everything I was thinking as well, which is quite bizarre, because every time I thought a question, they'd come up with the answer. And there were all different nationalities. People from all over the world were there with their guide. They couldn't have gone there otherwise. It was a magic experience, very humbling too. And we were all told what we were, what our role was.
Now, with regard to Space Brothers, obviously, coming from other planets, one would have thought they have their own form of communication that they use amongst themselves.
Oh, they do. They do, definitely. In fact, they communicate. Because thought is not heard, it doesn't help anybody else around. Now, I've discovered through the channeling, and it's quite impromptu quite often, that they can speak through me in their own language. And what is really, really interesting is that when they do it, it's usually healing somebody that's present. Whether that's an emotional healing or a physical healing, it doesn't seem to matter. It definitely heals and people feel it because the sound itself carries a vibration and the vibration has a healing effect. Now, what has been really, really odd lately is when I've used the language, another person present will also respond in an ET language. So we have a communication going, sometimes a three-way communication going. I've reached the point now where I can translate. I know that I can't translate word for word because it's not words, but I get the gist of what they want to say. So they've started doing that. Sometimes it sounds very Native American and you think, oh, this is Native American. Maybe it is. Where did the Native American language start? You know, right? From space, probably. All our languages originated from space, from thought. So, yes, I'm just asking them at the moment whether they want to say something for the record. But they speak so many different languages, I'm just asking. while I'm talking to you. I think that's enough. What they're saying is, the gist is, that they're very happy to be able to make themselves known in this way, because they're here all the time anyway. They're often with me. They will often speak in their language while I'm watching the television, like making a comment on what they've just seen through me, you see. It's quite interesting, really. And I love it. It makes me feel good. So I love just doing it. And people who are present, they seem to love it as well, provided I don't spend the whole evening doing it, of course.
Do we know the origins of this particular language that you spoke?
No, because I'm so focused on saying it that I'm not also saying at the same time, who are you from, where are you from?
Hmm.
I will get to that, but I haven't got that far yet. I just accept that they are from another planet. That one felt, that was another person there. Because, you see, they don't just come singly. Often there's a little group want to speak. That one felt more of a Native American one.
So you are permanently connected?
Only if I think about them.
Right.
If I'm otherwise, you know, I'm switched off.
It's like tuning in a radio or something.
Yeah, you have to mentally think of somebody. Now, if you wanted to think of one of your children, you know, your mind would be with them, wouldn't it, straight away? But you're not walking around all the time thinking of them. So spaceships, I like being on them. They have what I've called the looking glass. In hindsight, I've called it the looking glass, because when I went on board, several times actually, they have a sort of viewing room, and they just wave their hands, and the picture comes up for what they want to show me, and it covers, it's like a wall, whole wall thing. And most of it was about the planet, well, all of it is about the planet, actually. What's going to happen on the planet? What can happen on the planet?
Oh, it's showing you future potential future events.
Yes, based on our actions now.
Gosh.
Our mind actions now.
So you're seeing a video.
Yeah, but it's this old screen, wall.
Of a potential future event.
Of a potential future. So that's why I call it the looking glass. I tried to change when I was on board, because Andreas, the guy who took me, and Dr. Poe, who takes me, they just do that, you see, and the picture comes on or off and changes his light on the television, you know, you have a little light flashing in the corner. I tried nothing, absolutely nothing, and they laugh because they said, you don't have the vibration for it, you know, I just can't do it.
You need an Xbox Kinect for that.
I need something, but I didn't have the... Obviously, I wasn't capable of doing it, but they could. And it's amazing, because you might get somebody coming on, another ET, who would do a long speech about what is expected, not of me personally, of human beings, you know. And that's all in the book, because all of it's recorded, which is amazing, because I have the tape recordings of it.